Hello, everyone. Honored to see you. My name is Kang Li from CertiK. I'm currently the CTO at CertiK. I also feel honored to get invited here as a guest speaker for WEMADE event. I was a player of the legend, and that's really lots of memory in the past. And plus, for CertiK, we feel like it's a great honor to be able to work with WeMix and WeMade. So first, I want to tell our collaboration with WeMix, and I feel that's also like it's a journey, and it's a journey to both the collaboration and also the development of CertiK company. So I joined the company about two and a half years ago. That's about the time I believe that WeMade and WeMix had worked with CertiK. We started with just the initial chain auditing. CertiK at that time mostly doing smart contract auditing, the chain auditing. We are a security provider. We are a partner at that time, but it's mostly on a security auditing on a single cases. And gradually, I believe it's because WeMade and WeMix are satisfied with our service. We become a routine and later exclusive service provider for all the chain development and even project in the whole WeMix ecosystem. So we end up by the number provided by our business team, we have already done more than 160 plus project and update auditing for WeMade. Then after that, we also provide the incident monitoring alert. So CertiK right now is monitoring the incident and the chain events on the WeMix and also other chain on the whole Web3 ecosystem. And along that, we also provide a compliance service. So we turned from a partnership between just the security smart contract auditing to a full security service providing partner, including compliance and also security monitoring. And after that, our collaboration move up one more step. And we start to provide even node services for the WeMade chain. And we are become validators. And we also become a long-term holder for the WeMade chain. So that certainly grows our company's business, and it also made our collaboration between WeMade and also CertiK much deeper. And now we are also entering some collaboration on the stablecoin one, as the VP Mr. Kim mentioned. And we all believe that's a huge potential and going to have a huge impact on the Korean and also the global market. So that's a journey I want to emphasize for both my experience at CertiK and also CertiK's business growth and then also CertiK partnership with WeMade. We feel really grateful for the collaboration. So first I come here again, want to say thank you. Then I want to also take the opportunity to give a quick introduction to people here in case you don't know much about the our company, because here for sure you all know WeMade and WeMix. So CertiK is a company created a few years ago at New York City by two professors, Professor Shao from Yale University and Professor Ronghui Gu from the Columbia University. They are experts in the area called formal verification, so they apply this to the Web3 security field. And right now we are well-funded. We have been received venture capital from lots of well-known VCs. I'm not going to go into detail on that. There's also lots of projects. For right now, we are considered the largest Web3 security provider because according to CMC and CoinGecko, most of the project listed there, about 60 to 70% of the project are provided security service from CertiK. So those are just a list of icons. Again, as I mentioned, CertiK grows from beginning as a security provider, along with the collaboration with WeMix. We become a full service provider for all kinds of need for Web3 projects. including, of course, security auditing, but also we provide venture, we provide compliance services, we provide monitoring, bug bounty, and so on. And the same thing as we already offered to WeMix. One more item I want to emphasize, especially related to stablecoin, that over the years, as a global company, we have already worked with multiple regulation and different countries, different regions. Specifically, I list a few here. Our CEO right now serves as the advisor on the Singapore MAS. And in fact, Singapore is, as the VP Mr. Kim mentioned, Singapore is one of the leading countries on the stablecoin policy regulation. They are actually a pioneer on giving license to companies on stablecoin issuer. The very first license was given to a company called Paxo G, and they are our customer. So we are actually completely behind their application, and we are not only their security auditor, we are even some of the solution, in their solution, we are also developer. So that's in the Singapore. And also I want to emphasize in Hong Kong. So in Hong Kong, they have a Web3 development task force. Our CEO is also one of the 13 external members. I myself also serve on the regulation and stablecoin subcommittees as an external advisor there. So I was deeply involved in the Hong Kong stablecoin policy development. In fact, I can also mention that, you know, even Hong Kong is a, you know, overall economy is much smaller, but they also try to become a leading region, try to issue license for stablecoin. In fact, in early this year, like August 1st, they already announced a policy, a public policy, allow company to apply for license. So far, there's no company get a license yet. There was four company, actually three company in the sandbox last year, and then there's one more here. And CertiK is behind three out of the four company right now are leading in the sandbox stablecoin application in the application group. And right now, there are, what I heard is that there are more than 70 company are applying license, stablecoin license in Hong Kong. Of course, I believe in South Korea, there's also a really active regulation development happening there. We are also working with a few other regions. I'm not going to go into detail, but we are actually trying to make compliance regulation support as one of the major focus for our company. And then the rest, I'm going to go through a few sample achievements. I'm not going to go to too much detail, but at the end, I do want to talk a little bit about our effort on stablecoin. So in the past, we have been working on all kinds of projects from the chain level up to the application. Then here, this slide really shows some public acknowledgement from the chain and application we have worked on. I'm not going to go into detail here. I do want to mention that we are also recently working with a lot of large enterprise traditional bank that are actually moving into Web3 field, including banks in US, in Singapore, in Hong Kong, in Paris. They have a huge interest in getting into the, you know, virtual assets, especially recently on the payment and on the also on the stable coin. The one more thing I want to mention is, of course, since CertiK is mostly serving the Web3 company, we have been working with lots of large exchange. Binance is actually our investor, one of the early investors. So we have a good relationship with Binance, and we also work with OKX, Bybit, crypto.com, and a few others. And then, of course, we also work with ecosystem, and you can see that, you know, WeMix is one of our long-term partner. We also have partner with a company like Ripple, for example, very active in payment and stablecoin. We are actually behind their stablecoin security auditing. We are also behind Ripple's stablecoin work jointly with PayPal. So PayPal has a stablecoin, but is actually working with Ripple. And so the very last part I do want to mention is about our effort on stablecoin. As I mentioned earlier, we already having started to have an ongoing collaboration with WeMix. What I'm going to talk next is just briefly saying how we approach this work. This content is based on our experience with the Hong Kong stablecoin policy. In the Hong Kong, if a company want to apply stablecoin, you would need to have a statement about your business scenario, how you're going to use stablecoins. They care a lot on that. They don't want you simply say you want to have a stablecoin without saying what is the purpose. Once you have that declaration description, then the application need to have all these five components. Of course, you need to have a smart contract, your token implementation. That's all the stablecoin needed. Of course, but then more importantly, you need to show that you have a user platform, you have a platform able to issue stablecoin, and also monitoring the circulation. Make sure your circulation is definitely within the reserved assets limit. And in Hong Kong, they have daily requirement, ask you to report this to the regulator, and then also monthly report and so on. And there's also lots of required policies, mostly try to address different type of risk, including the token on-chain risk, and then also the off-chain, the reserve assets risk, your third-party risk, and your management risk. Overall, there's probably, we counted close to 70 to 90 policy document procedure need to be provided and implemented. And with all those, you can then apply and then, hopefully later get license. Now, overall in this process, what can we do? What's our focus? We want to emphasize that when a company or when a business want to apply stablecoin or work with stablecoin, you should really consider at least three group of risk. Right now, the regulation mostly focusing on circulation, proof of assets, make sure you have enough assets reserved mapping to your circulation, and also make sure you can able to redeem it when the client need it. However, there's other type of risk. Of course, CertiK will look at the token risk, we look at the chain risk. But I also want to emphasize one type, it's called operational risk. Stablecoin is not just a smart contract, not just the smart contracts plus your reserve assets. You will still need help people to manage the contract, manage the mint, burn, blacklisting, your redemption. That procedure and then operation, and that custodian part, again, as early on the keynote, our VP, Mr. Kim, mentioned that the custodian, how to let user use it. But the management of stablecoin, the custodian part, also very important. I want to use that chance to mention that you really need to look at a comprehensive review to look at all the risk. And we are really proud that when we work with WeMix in the past, we have helped so many protecting so many projects in the chain. So we feel confident we can also work on stablecoin to help WeMix to make sure we address all the risk and mitigate risk as much as possible. That's all I have. And if you have any question, I will be here. We'll be very happy to answer any questions. So again, our view and our vision is that we want to provide comprehensive service to Web3 and also traditional finance company that who want to get into the Web3. We want to carry everything that needed through the whole Web3 journey. And we really appreciate being invited here again. And we are proud to be a WeMix partner. Thank you so much.